Lots of stuff is based off the hinge patterns. We want to make sure that we're doing this correctly first, which is why we're starting with it. It's really useful if you have a stick, a dowel, a golf club, shovel, whatever it may be, but something like this to use as a cue. So essentially what a hinge is sticking your butt back and then bringing your hips forward. It's hinging at your hips. You'll get some movement in the knees, a little bit in, and maybe the back a little bit and some other areas, but primarily it is a hips back and hips forward. So you wanna think, if I karate chop myself in the hips, booty goes toward the wall, and then I wanna stand tall, bringing my belt buckle forward. A key component of this though, is when we do this, is we're not leaning or swaying back, and then when we go forward with our butt going backward, we don't wanna round at the spine. Those are the two most common problems that happen with this, where we bend too much at the back as opposed to using the hips. So we'll start with the stick. What we want to do is place the stick on our back. From here, we want to make sure that the head, the mid back, and the tailbone, or your butt crack, is touching the stick. I'm going to hold it like so. Get an idea of where you're at, because if we're here and we're not connected, we first want to make sure that we get all three of those spots connected. From here, if we have a big arch in the back, which tends to happen, we want to clear that space by thinking of tucking your tail or giving yourself a little bit of a plumber butt. So you want to tilt your pelvis backward, lifting your belt buckle up towards your nose. If you have a hard time with this, what you first want to start with is going on hands and knees and simply doing what I call a J-Lo booty and a plumber butt. J-Lo booty, plumber butt. We should be able to arch and round our low back without using our upper back and neck. We should be able to isolate like this. So first start with this. As long as you can do that movement there, that J-Lo booty, plumber butt, J-Lo booty meaning arched butt toward the ceiling, plumber butt meaning rounding down. If we can do those two things, we can get into position with the hinge. So now that we take the stick and we get connected here, feet will be about shoulder width apart, slight bend in the knees. I'm gonna plumber butt just a little bit to clear this space here. So there's a big arch right now, and I'm gonna tuck under or plumber butt to flatten it out. From here, now all I wanna do is maintain this while I stick my booty back and then stand tall. So I'm simply gonna stick my butt back and then stand tall, maintaining connection with the stick. Which what typically happens if you don't have the stick is that when people hinge forward, they start to round the back, and as you can see, the stick is lifting off my tailbone. And then when we stand up, people tend to sway back and arch their back like this, creating this big space here. So again, we want to make sure to clear that space, hinge back, stand tall, maintaining that. Now it may take some repetitions to get this. That is totally okay. Another thing you can do is take one of your bands, attach it to your anchor, and then jump inside of it. When you jump inside of it and place it around your waistline, this gives you some feedback. So you can do the same thing. Find your positioning, which we call neutral spine or your neutral spine, and then let the band pull your booty back until you feel a stretch in the hamstrings, and then slowly stand tall, pushing that band forward. That band gives you feedback of pulling you back, and then you have to push forward against it. So you should feel like your booty is pushing through the band and then letting the hips come back. Now that we have the hinge down, we can go to our first move, which is the goat bag. It's the same thing, it's just now using a weight. So we'll take one of your weights. I'm gonna take one of my lighter kettlebells. If you have one, that's fine, but you can really use anything, just some sort of weight at your front. From here, the goat bag is simply holding that weight here, and you're going to hinge back and then slowly come up. Hinge back, slowly come up. If you want to make this slightly harder, what you can do is hinge back, drop the weight down, and then curl it back up as you stand tall. This starts to groove a pattern for a kettlebell swing, which we do about once or twice later on in the program. Not absolutely necessary, but the kettlebell swing a lot of people do. Looks simple, but it's actually a lot more complicated. So we want to hold off on that till we really have this pattern grooved. The next one is going to be a single leg hinge. So we do the same hinge deal, but now we're on one leg. So I'm going to take my left leg, and I'm going to put my weight into that, and my right leg is going to stand like a kickstand. So now I have most of my weight on my one leg. With this, you want to make sure your hip, your knee, and your ankle all stay in alignment. We don't want the knee coming out or the knee coming in. If you have a hard time with balance with this, you may need to put a little bit more weight on that kickstand leg. One of the moves we do in the single leg pattern or stance is our skaters or star pattern. Simply, you get into that position, so you want to be hinged first. This is important. And then this leg comes here, and simply you're going to kick your leg back like you're skating. If we're not in this hinge position, you won't feel that glute or that butt working. And what will happen is that you'll feel a lot of your quad. But that typically happens when we're too upright and that knee's coming forward. If you hinge first and you feel the slight stretch or pull of the hamstrings and you're in this leaning forward position, and then you set up, you'll immediately start to feel that glute working. And especially if you start adding movement here, that's gonna start really kicking on, and you should feel that outside of the hip and the glute working there. Now, the add-on to that is a star pattern. It's very simple. It's the same exact thing, but now we're gonna imagine we're inside of a star and we're creating a star pattern with our opposite leg. So I'm gonna reach up here and then back here, across, across, and back. And you can do any variation of this as you want. It doesn't have to be an exact star, it's just what we call it. Good, and now just for me doing this, I'm already feeling this glute working. The next step is gonna be the single leg deadlift. This is a little more challenging. It's gonna require a little more control. Same idea, single leg, hip, knee, ankle stay in alignment. Make sure your foot stays flat. We're not arching it and we're not collapsing it inward, not lifting the toes up or the heels. That foot should stay relatively relaxed. If you have not the best stability or balance, you're gonna feel that foot really clinching and grabbing a lot. We wanna try and reduce that as much as possible. So with this, it's a hinge, but with a single leg. So what it looks like is that I'm gonna hinge the same way I usually do, except I'm gonna kick this leg back as I reach forward, creating the letter T with my body, and then slowly bring it up to the letter I. Letter T, letter I. When I add some weight, it's gonna make it a little more challenging. The easiest is gonna be holding it with two hands, letter T, letter I. A little harder is the same side leg and same side arm holds the weight. Letter T, letter I. And then the hardest is gonna be opposite arm, opposite leg. So I'm on my left leg, so I'm using my right arm. Letter T, letter I. Slow and controlled. And a key component with this is that when you go down, if you look at me, my hips stay parallel with the ground. This really challenges your hips and your stability. What a lot of us will do if we don't have good control is as we go down, you'll start to see the hips open up like so. And when we open up like this, one, it's not challenging the muscles we want, and two, we're just kind of hanging off our joints and there's gonna be a lot of squirreling around. We don't really want that. So if you watch me here, instead of staying parallel my hips with the ground, if I go down and do it incorrectly, you're gonna see this opening up where you can see my belt buckle. We don't want that, especially if we're doing same arm, same leg. It's a lot easier just to open up your body like this than staying parallel with the ground.